Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. My late father, he did the analysis of religion very scientifically and methodically. And he presented the thing in a tabular form, easy to grasp. So here is the first table which he had drawn, and there's the gist of it. All beings, animals, human beings, are born with the physical body of five tattva, we call it, five elements, they call it, you know, in religious language. So here is the progression in spirituality. So those people who conceive their tribal identity knowingly, they are sons of Satan. You know, the tribal identity in this age is not known to everybody, but there are some people who know their tribal identity, but they conceal it, because they have to do some satanic work, irresponsible work. So under the cover of another identity, then they perform satanic deeds. As Khatri, you know, when they became Mohammedans, they changed their tribal identity from Khatri to Sheikh. But in their in underground, you know, in their family trees, they know who they are, but the surname they use is quite different. So this is a typical example of how they conceive this, their tribal identity, knowingly they are sons of Satan. They cannot live in peace, and they are enemies of the sons of man. This is amply reflected among the Jews outwardly. Remember that a Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. So such a Jew is a spiritual self who is inwardly. But one who is a Jew outwardly, he is a son of Satan or he is a tear. And that's those people who are making them Jews outwardly, the temple rabbis, John the Baptist, he addressed them as brood of vipers. Brood of vipers mean they kill people on the basis of religious rites and other things. So they are sons of Satan, you know, the Jews who are our physical self. And the tears, when Jesus was born, they were mostly Jews of the physical self, especially of the people of Judah tribe. The other tribal people were not so fanatic. For the safety of the baby Jesus, he was taken to the land of the sons of man. You remember Egypt. People over there, although they were poor, they did not change their tribal identity. So the baby Jesus was taken from chosen a promised land to the land of Ishmael, the Arab people, Egyptians. So here then is the one who do not conceal their tribes. Because when you were born, you were not born of your own free will. It is our father who cast you in certain family or a certain tribal people. So if I was born of Jat family, it was not my choice. It's my father who gave me the birth in a Jat family. Similarly, people are born in English, Scotch, Irish, etc. It's all our father gave you the birth. So we should not reject his will. Those people who do not conceal their tribal identity, they are entitled to join the first religious community called Hindu. So if you do not conceal your tribal identity, then you can join the first religious community that gives you the moral education pertaining to our physical body. That is called Hindu in India, Ibrahimi Millat in Middle East. The duty of the Hindu is to establish their tribal existence by killing the sons of Satan, the tares, as it happened during the Holocaust. Remember, if you see these Holocaust Jewish people, they are nice people. They are the demonstration nation of the world, and that's why they are called nation of priests. So through their mistakes and through their sacrifices, they teach us the lesson. This thing will happen if you do this thing. But if we ignore their warning, then we are not appreciating their sacrifices. So these tales, you know, when they became sons of Satan, physical. So the duty of the Hindu is to establish their tribal existence by killing the sons of Satan, the tares, as it happened during the Holocaust. Remember that this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam, man, and not for the sons of Satan. So if you break your covenant with Adam, then you have no right to live on this planet Earth. So this planet Earth is for the tribal people, races, and other things that are the identity of the physical body, and not for the, this planet is not for the habitation of Jews, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. So if you become a Muslim, Christian, etc., physical self, then you are a tear, and you will be fanatic and you will get killed. So this is natural, as planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam, or wheat plants that bear fruit. So their duty is to speak the secular truth and uphold their extrinsic values or extrinsic honor. So that's why the flag of the Hindu temple is red, blood red, because they have to give their sacrifice in order to protect or safeguard the interest of their country. So this is normal. So then this one, you know, the one which are Hindus, then they are can divided into again two. Those Hindus who remain stupid are the once born stones. Stones mean thick-headed. They cannot join the second spiritual community of Sikhs, Christ, Muslims, etc. Now I use the word Christ because Christian is adjective. Christians are people of the book. So if you want to be a man of spirit, then you have to be a noun, which is Christ. So the inner man, which Paul has stressed, to renew your inner man every day, and that inner man is sitting in the temple of God. And one who sits in the temple of God is a Christ, not a rabbi. Rabbis sit in the brick-built temple. So in Jesus we are Christ and not Christians. Christians are people of the book who are dead in spirit. So egoistic people are the natural once-born persons, are the enemies of the twice-born spiritual people. But the natural men, having no sense, always fight among themselves. If they are not guided by a rabbi or a Brahmin. So if they do not go under the supervision of a good rabbi or a Brahmin, then they try to fight with each other. But when their rabbi is there, then they will go to him and he will then settle their dispute peacefully, and both will be happy. So one should not be concerned with these extrinsic or the external troublemakers or enemies, but with the five internal or intrinsic enemies, which are well known in India as Kaam, Krodh, Lobh, Moh, Ahankar. And that, if not overpowered, make you an infidel or kafir. So if you don't overpower those five temptations, then you become an infidel, and so they have become useless. So now those people, you know, those Hindus of the people of the first community, those Hindus, the natural men who manage to overpower their ego. Manage to overpower the ego mean that if they come to know that when they were born in a certain tribal family, say English, German, French, they were not born of their own free will, but it is our Father, God, who gave you the birth in certain family. So somebody is born in Africa. His color is black. So people who are born in Europe, they should not hate them, because their soul inside, that counts in God, not the physical body. So when they don't hate them, they love each other. That love is called agape, divine love. Eros is between the first Hindus, and the agape between Sikh, Christ and Muslims. So those Hindus are the natural men who manage to overpower their ego and become twice born, should seek his treasures from an apostolic or a saintly person to become a Sikh, Muslim or Christ. So unless you have Christ in your heart, you can't preach gospel. So spiritual knowledge is to one's mind, called MUNN in Punjabi or NAFS in Arabic. So it is to our soul, you know, which is awakened, and not to our physical body, and not to the physical body or the lesser brain of instincts that controls the physical body. Remember, our physical body is controlled by this lesser brain, and if somebody hit you on the back of the neck, then you can die. So that is the seat of the lesser brain. Physical self, which we call tan in Punjabi or jism in Urdu, needs moral education. So the people who are Hindus dealing with physical self, they need moral education. While when you are twice born, then you need spiritual education. So this is what it is about Sikh. The religious duty or dharma of a Sikh is to know his word and to become contented. So this Sikh, you perform these all religious reading, all that knowledge for you to uplift your intrinsic values, spiritual values. So you don't bother about what the others say, but you preach your gospel to them. If they reject it, it's their then fate. Sikh is to know his word and to become contented. This is the second community. They ply the double-edged sword of his word. In Punjabi, we call it khanda, which is a double-edged sword. Sikhs should be careful of the mammon worshipping hypocrites called Judas Iscariots. So remember that in Christianity and in other things, people, you know, they donate, while the Judas Iscariot, they take money out. In the next video, I will explain more.